So besides this place being beautiful, it is also very big. There's steps going all over the place, so I feel like before we go to the quest, we should explore. Like any good RPG player, we need to explore. So, we've got plenty of stuff to read ahead of us. Are there things... Can I read anything on here? The answer is no. Can we explore in here? Oh, yeah, no, we totally can. Read. The Emporium of Mortal Means. For all matters defensive concern, offensive intent, and study of arts martial, and, with sanction, magical. So this is like a shop? The fanciest damn shop there ever was. Out of the way, team! Yup. Madam, you are looking fabulous, if I do say so myself.
Not open today. Not until this fast is over, at least. Too many swords out.
I was just complimenting you. You can't even take time to talk to me? You're making armor for giants. Giant skeletons. Can't take time to talk to me about that? Fine, be that way. All right. What about this way? Holy crap. The hell are you doing in here, Hammerhead? Just popping out of the ocean.
You'll forgive if events are a little too flustered for commerce. Nothing personal, Inquisition.
Yeah, okay. Whatever you say, man. Not gonna question you. You clearly have more taste than I will ever have. What is that? Is that a city guard? Yep. We got a guard. Can I read these plaques? Yup! Grace of the Empire, North. This display, reserved for discourse political, with attending professors of social matters from the University of Orlais. Note that all vendors of loftable groceries will be closed in the hours beforehand and for 1/2 hour after. Interesting. Is this... Oh, yep. No, this says something. In respect to Duke Isidore de Alencins. Definitely not his name. It is now, though. That's how I said it. The First Lion of Orlais. In respect to Emperor Alphonse Valmont. The Lions of Orlais. A repeating element dedicated to the great defenders otherwise noted. It is rumored that one is gold, one is bronze and weighted with poison, one is chocolate, and one is watching. Uh-huh. As the saying goes, dare we all a thief to test his back and learn which is most dangerous to try, deny, or lay? In truth, they're all lead. So, there you go. Alright, I'm worried about these guys over there. They seem like the type that would string me up. Fanciful headdress and all. They're not a fan of what I'm wearing. That's like, oh, far too plain. Grace of the Empire East. Welcome all before the Grace of the Empire. Stage and audience for the use of all. For theater and business, for partnership and proposal. Be seen! A notice below reads, this display reserved for songs traditional by Lord Bramford and his players. Cancelled. Okay. Can I talk to these guys? I'm so worried about this. Hello, gents?
Stand wary, guardsman. The Inquisition is here, along with the Herald of Andraste.
That's the mage they say killed the divine.
Let him pass. The Inquisition is the Templar's problem, and they'll fix it.
Oh, good, because I thought we were going to have to fight. I didn't want to have to fight some dudes who look like badasses. If I can get the armor of those, like, magey-looking dudes, that is sweet. Okay, what about this thing? Read. The fourth line of Orlais. In respect to Duke Stefan of Valmondrain. All right, what about this over here? Reserved for his strangeness, her sound, and his static puppets behind glass. There's one around the corner. Oh, shoot.
Good people of Val Royal, hear me. Together, we mourn our divine. Her naive and beautiful heart silenced by treachery. You wonder what will become of her murderer. Well, wonder no more.
Hi, everyone.
Behold, the so-called Herald of Andraste, claiming to rise where our beloved fell.
Cass is like, you gonna let him talk about you like that?
We say this is a false prophet. The Maker would say no mage in our hour of need.
Whoa. I never claimed to be. Let's talk peacefully. Yeah, let's talk peacefully. It doesn't matter about me. It's about saving the world. Oh, we have a real enemy. Yeah, that's a better one.
You say I am the enemy. The breach in the sky is our true enemy. We must unite to stop it.
It's true. The Inquisition seeks only to end this madness before it is too late.
It is already too late.
What now?
The Templars have returned to the Chantry. They will face this Inquisition, and the people will be safe once more.
Oh! Damn! He cold-cocked her!
Still yourself. She is beneath us.
What? First off, that guy stole my hat. Secondly, what are you doing punching her? Save me the trouble. Am I supposed to... Not here for us, then? How dare you? We were having a conversation.
What's the meaning of this? Her claim to authority is an insult, much like your own.
Lord Seeker Lucius, it's imperative that we speak with...
You will not address me.
Lord Seeker?
Creating a heretical movement, raising up a puppet as Andraste's prophet, you should be ashamed. You should all be ashamed. The Templars failed no one when they left the Chantry to purge the mages. You are the ones who have failed. You who'd leash our righteous swords with doubt and fear. If you came to appeal to the Chantry, you are too late. The only destiny here that demands respect is mine.
Wow, you are an asshole. Help us close the breach. Then what the hell are you doing here if that's the case?
If you're not here to help the Chantry, then you just came to make speeches.
I came to see what frightens old women so, and to laugh.
But Lord Seeker, what if he really was sent by the Maker? What if...
You are called to a higher purpose. Do not question.
I will make the Templar Order a power that stands alone against the Void. We deserve recognition. Independence. You have shown me nothing, and the Inquisition, less than nothing. Templars, Val Royo is unworthy of our protection. We march.
Charming fellow, isn't he?
Has Lord Seeker Lucius gone mad?
How well do you know that guy? Because I'm getting, like, Dragon Age high school vibes off of him. Like, he's with the cool kids, and you'll never fit in here at Dragon Age High. By the way, that should be your next game, Bioware.
Do you know him very well?
He took over the Seekers of Truth 2 years ago, after Lord Seeker Lambert's death. He was always a decent man, never given to ambition and grandstanding. This is very bizarre.
Maybe he lost someone at the explosion? Will he see reason? I mean, it doesn't seem like he will. It seems like he's an ass. We'll find another way.
Fortunately, the Templars aren't our only hope.
I wouldn't write them off so quickly. There must be those in the Order who see what he's become. Either way, we should first return to Haven and inform the others.
All right. First, we should explore around here. Hello, Belle. How are you? Besides being strangely headless?
Ever since our divine was murdered. Toothless old fools are lost without
her. Is what they're saying
real?
What
are the Grand Clerics doing
while the main circles
lie empty?
The Inquisition's going to fix the hole in the sky?
That's the plan.
We're going to give it a try, at least.
No one is doing anything. The Chantry is useless, and the Templars, Andraste, I never thought they'd abandon us. Listen, your camp will need food. I have contacts. We'll have deliveries there in days.
Nice!
You want to help the Inquisition?
Never been part of something this big before, but if your Inquisition's going to seal the sky, I want to help.
Cassandra? Yeah, Cassandra, go for it.
What do you think, Cassandra?
I think the woman is asking you and not me.
Well, he is...
the Herald of Andraste. Yes, I understand. Haven is a mess, but we won't turn away anyone willing to help. Invite her, if it pleases you.
All right, go to Haven.
Head to Haven, then. We need good people.
Nice!
I don't know if I'm that, but it will be nice to see. Thank you.
No, we got Varric. It doesn't matter if you're good or not. Just good at your job. Dude, that's sweet. Very cool. What about you, bro? You just... oh,
shit. What's that? An arrow with a message?
What the hell is this? Favors for friends. A message is attached, written in large flowing hand and bordered with doodles. People say you're special. I want to help. And I can bring everyone. Oh my goodness. There's a baddie in Valroyo. I hear he wants to hurt you. Have a search for the red things in the market, the docks, and round the cafe, and maybe you'll meet him first. Bring swords. Friends of Red Jenny. So what, is this on my map now? Holy moly, it definitely is. Also, there are question marks out the wazoo. One's up there. Oh my goodness. Okay, we can go up to the second level. But how do we get to the second level? I assume stairs. Ooh, we can go back to them and Hammerhead. Well, we need to do all that. Hello, everyone. Oh, there's like 50,000 things to read around here. What is this? She of the Highwaymen repents. Gallows, master, hold thy hand. Hold it back a while. Callous juror, let me stand. Let me bear a smile. For comes my brother distant. For comes my savior soon. I stand here most insistent. I will receive my boon. Fellow soldier, hold thy voice. Hold it, if you may. Fallow shoulders, show my choice. I am in your sway. For know my crime was cruel, and all my pain deserved. I stand here as a fool, despite my brother served. Mother dearest, look away, look into the sun. Other nearest, gone astray, you will be undone. For no more will I prattle, and no more will I pray. Here you must the rattle, as life will fly away. How many people do they have who write poetry for them? On staff there at Bioware.
Well, that was a change.
We'll grab this. Emperor Florian. Grand Duke Florian was not supposed to ascend the Elysian throne. His elder brother, Emperor Judiciel II, had two twin sons and thus a very secure line. Florian was free to pursue his interests, much like you are, to continue reading about this. I'll just scroll down a bit, I will, and then a little bit more, so that you might pause. And if you are interested in finding out more about this, by all means, please do. It is something you should read. I, however, shan't, because I'm a man who wants to get through this game, and not take 12,000 years. Besides, it's all color, commentary, and text. Does not matter the actual game, unless it does, in which case you will have read it and will post in the comments that I am stupid for passing up such an opportunity. Can I run up here and jump off? Like, rock on! Oh, there was something back here. What am I missing? Oh, no, there is nothing, in fact, back there. Examine a tree? What? La pomme vie et morte. It is said that the apples that grow near the gallows will be bitter on the tongue of a lover who will betray. It is also said, although by different people entirely, that unripened fruit should not be the only consideration when investigating matters of fidelity. The latter are lonely most evenings among the arbors of the summer bazaar. That's cute. Okay, so who's this guy? He's my thing, right?
I believe that messenger is trying to get our attention.
He's doing a piss poor job of it, just standing there. Hello?
You are the Herald of Andraste, are you not? I have an invitation for you.
To do what now? Invitation, First Enchanter Vivienne. You are cordially invited to attend my salon held at the Chateau of Duc Bastien de Gislen. Sure, okay. Can we go see this? Oh my god, there's so much to read. Knot of heroes, united in hatred. If we are re-examining motive, let us not stop at the sons of the betrayer. For the first leader of Young Olay after the sons was Jess Havis, Chatel wife of two of them. But examine the facts. Examine the fact that I'm already tongue-twisted. Examine the fact that you could probably read this on your own. So I'm going to scroll through for you now. Here we go. There we go, guys. There's a lot of flavor. There's a lot of flavors in this game. Lots of flavors. All right, is there anything over here worth reading? I'm going to say no. Still pings, huh? Guess because it's like, there's an exit. Also, there's this thing over here.
The Templars didn't even touch you.
They know I'm a badass. They walked. They straight up walked. This has to be the chocolate one. In respect of Duke Yvonne of Savarin. Yep, chocolate. What's this one say? Grace of the Empire West. This display reserved for presentations of affection as though private and also discounted spirits. Presented by Company Misdirect Theater. All right, let's go see these two guys. Hammerhead, what's up?
Well, this has all been a frustrating mess. Templars and Chantry and especially the mages. Just everything. I apologize if you were refused service, but we are now open for business. Especially if you put my words to use.
All right, well, that's nice. I mean, I guess I could put your wares to use. The question is, do I need to? Oh, and then just open up the other one. So I don't need to see both. All right, well. Hammerhead's cool. That other lady just snubbed me. She just straight out snubbed me. Oh, is this guy open too? Yeah, all the merchants are open now. Delightful. All right, well, let's go back over here.
They left us. The Templars left us to the mages.
And that's your damn problem.
Liars.
Oh, hey, what's up? Can I talk to her? Hello? Oh, damn, she got pushed right out of the way. Madam, are you? Oh, I definitely
can. This victory must please you greatly, Seeker Cassandra.
We came here seeking only to speak with the mothers. This is not our doing, but yours.
And you had no part in forcing our hand? Do not delude yourself. Now we have been shown up by our own Templars, in front of everyone. And my fellow clerics have scattered to the wind, along with their convictions. Just tell me one thing. If you do not believe you are the Maker's chosen, then what are you?
I'm just someone who can help.
Someone who can help close the breach and end this madness.
That is more comforting than you might imagine. I suppose it is out of our hands now. We shall all see what the Maker plans in the days to come.
Yeah, no, we need to further investigate. How many of the Templars rebelled now?
How many Templars turned on the Chantry, exactly?
They rebelled across Thedas. Some remained loyal, but not enough to call them the Order. The White Spire here in the capital was the largest garrison, but now it stands empty. Perhaps more shall flock to the Lord Seeker's banner now. How far has faith waned, I wonder?
So, I assume asking this, we probably have our answer, but let's ask it.
How are people responding to all of this?
Despair. Fear. We mourn Her Holiness. The people look to the sky and wonder how long before terror comes for us all. There must be a way through this. Is it you? The Templars? The Maker's will? We abandoned our duties. We servants of the faith. Now we can only pray.
What if we all work together and solve this and stop this craziness? You think that might work? What do you believe about me? Yeah, that's a good question.
You're obviously skeptical. What do you believe I am?
Our divine. Her holiness is dead. I have seen evidence for everything, except what would comfort me.
That doesn't answer my question.
For you to be true, a great many things must be false. And if you are false, a great many things must have failed. There is chaos ahead, whatever your intentions.
Dude, my intentions involve getting a group of badasses together, stopping some gate, finding one or two chicks to possibly get with, and getting drunk with Varric. That sounds like my plans. I think the Divine would be cool with that. What will the Chantry do now?
So what happens now? Will the Chantry continue to denounce me?
We have already done so. And what good has it done us? Now it falls on us to select a new Divine, if we can, and leave the next step to her.
Provided such a selection is even possible.
I truly don't know. Any revered mother who could have followed Justinia died at the Conclave. What becomes of us, and your Inquisition, is in the Maker's hands now.
Question. Why are you holding your side when you clearly got punched in the back of the head? I feel... She's like, my spleen! I feel like there's something wrong with this picture.
Where is the Lord Seeker taking the Templars?
I can't begin to guess the Lord Seeker's mind. He could not have abandoned his intended role more completely.
There must be sense to what we can't see.
Must there? Rebellion seems popular in certain quarters, doesn't it, Seeker? Is crafting the Templars into a new power really any worse than declaring a rival to the Chantry itself?
I'll stop this somehow.
There's got to be a way to calm everything down and clean up this mess.
I hope against hope that may be the case.
Great, well, nice conversation. I'm going to go this way. Maybe she was holding herself because my team kicked her across the damn stage there. While I understand concerns for propriety and the general dressing of the bazaar, I must caution that release is needed. So why don't we all dress like lunatics? Put on a hammerhead. Wear masks all the time. That's not weird. Let go. Let your fleek. Let your fleek flag fly. It's a rhyme. It's so lesion. Don't question it. There will be mourning and some things will happen. But you know what? We'll be good. Can I go up here? Madam? No, I cannot go in there. Watch this, lady. Yeah! What up, bros? Can't talk to anyone here. There's definitely things around here. Uh-oh. I just don't see any. What the hell? Oh, is that the sign that's highlighting? Wait, great ping.
Let's look around.
Reservoir stocking evaluation. Tremors, floating, taste is off. Water birds die off. Restocking failed. Fish not fit. Do not consume. Okay. Don't eat the fish. Read. Miroir de la mire. F it. I don't care that much at all. There you go, guys. Feel free to read that.
Speak only the word. Sing only the chant. Then the golden city is thine.
Well, there's a book back there. What is that? What is that? The Randy Dowager Quarterly. Ooh, here we go. Did I just level up reading erotic fiction? The Randy Dowager welcomes the blooms of spring with the collected Calypgian Curassiers. Being a scandalous representation of Her Majesty's favored, caught in flagrante delectable. Can their uniforms and modesty withstand the assault? The Randy Dowager exhibitions for the noble of thought, but spry of step. The lady herself says, hardly a tethras, but generally arousing if polished cuirass does it for you. And it should, Three scarves flooded in shock out of five. Yep. And I can't get that, so I assume I have to... Yeah. Key lifted from drunk swearing about Harold. Don't know what door. I'm out. My debt is paid.
The maker.
So there's a key out there? Water,
as the moth sees light and goes toward flame.
Interesting. Hopefully it's a key to the second floor, because so far I see no way to get up there. It's definitely on the map, but there's nothing around.
The Templars left us to the mages.
Uh-oh, we got another examine thing. Well, it's giving me XP. I'll examine it. The apples nearest the cafe are said to change their taste depending on whether one is walking toward or away from the gallows. Everything about them damn gallows. Yeah, it's supposed to be stairs or something leading up, but that is not the case. We've got what appears to be an inn. Can I go in there? No inn at the inn. We got a reed. Uh-huh, la masque de Leon. We cheered when honored was her might. But many more deserve a thought. For though she was the first a knight, her kin and kind have always fought. Something taken from, let's say, the Canterbury Tales. That's what that was like reading. Difficult and boring.
We maintain an Inquisition presence on Commander Cullen's orders.
I was about to say.
This has been received as you might expect.
Looked like one of my dudes. Holy shit. What is that? Need to get closer? What is that? The head of Madame Snappy Snips. Mascot of Le Masque du Lion. Named in jest, but genuinely respected. The Grand Mam, as she's also called, was the last dragon brought down by Sir Koenig, the previous owner of the cafe. A spirited hunter, Koenig came of age in the years following the sighting that named the era. While others were quick to assume the tales of ancient Navarran dragon hunters must have been exaggerated. He tracked the gradual increase in dragon number and size. Can he believe that he was yet to see the true return of the species? Boop-a-doop-a-doop-dee. And Madam Snappy Snips.
Yes, thank you.
We got a read over here? You reading more hardcore pornographies? Not of heroes. Mafarath and sacrifice. Andraste, our lady. The sword and the fire against Aventer, betrayed to the Empire in exchange for a kingdom. Mafarath, now synonymous with treachery, but would Andraste have won? And if not, what would we have lost? Let us look not just at the act, but at the why of it. Oh, this is one of those like alternate history things? That's kind of cool. That's a nice flavor. The flavor of alternate history. Alright, there you go. Enjoy the pauses. You mean the scarf that's right there? Thank your friends for helping good lady Karis. Saw those who asked about Harold entered third passage, could not stay to see them exit. What the what? Third passage? Third passages around here?
It's true.
Is it true? Third passages? Alright, can't go that way. We can't go that way. Guard, are there passages?
Be careful.
Of the passages? The secret passages?
I can't believe this.
I can't believe it either. I'm running down path. Uh-oh, read. The secret passage is over there. The Lover's Alcove. Every district has one. At least one. And the question must be, why is a place meant for dalliance declared in such an obvious way? And the answer, of course, is that they want to see you get it on. Alright, so like, hide out in the corner and kiss all over each other and then let people watch suspiciously through these. Like, ooh! These dudes over here are like the guys at every party who just lean up against the wall. Like, yeah, I'm cool. Maybe someone will come over and talk to me. And they see me coming, they're like, and then I go over here and read this. Her Majesty's convenience.
Yes,
for Her Majesty's convenience, wood and vines defy the very sun and rain. Look at that guy. Is he scratching his balls? What are you doing?
Just sitting over here, scratching my balls. What is this? Knot of Heroes. They love these alternate history things. What could hold back an empire? Another. What could hold back so defined a people as Deventer? Another. What could hold back a playthrough? Too many damn books. So what could do that? Alright, so there you go. Close.
Of course.
Oh, sister, what's up?
What? Yes, I'm sorry. Minding the duties of the ailing mother, Havara, I am rather overwhelmed. Forgive me. I am unsure whether I meant to extend Chantry services to you, and that troubles me greatly.
All right, well, glad we had this talk.
It was silence. Then the voice of the Maker rang out.
Got some more guys over here. We got a shop. Maker. Oh, we got a shop that we definitely can go into. The question is, do I need to go into this shop? No, I definitely don't want to go into a shop. What I want to do is get up here. Stairs. We have two stairs to go to, and both lead up. Yes, question is, can we get up here? Go. They're just jumping. No, we can't. What? Can we go this way? I assume we can't do this yet. It started me on a quest I can't do. You sons of guns. Okay, let's go. Map it. World map. And then search the upper market. Well, I can't get there yet. We'll go back to Haven. Unless that... Because I kept talking about a secret passage. You know what? I'll come back to it later. All right, travel. Yes.
If I might have a moment of your time...
Who are you?
Grand Enchanter Fiona?
Leader of the Mage Rebellion.
Say what?
Is it not dangerous for you to be here?
I heard of this gathering, and I wanted to see the fabled Herald of Andraste with my own eyes. If it's help with the breach you seek, perhaps you should look among your fellow mages.
In return... Oh, that's a very... Yeah, in return for what? I think that's the big question, but... I probably should... The big secret guy should have been there, too. I imagine they sent, like, envoys. That's a good question, but I think I know the answer to that. There's no reason for them to be there. In return for what? Yeah, that's a good question.
And what do you want in exchange for the mage's help?
Oh, I haven't promised the Inquisition our help yet.
Oh, okay, then.
Consider this an invitation to Redcliffe. Come, meet with the mages. An alliance could help us both, after all. I hope to see you there. Au revoir, my Lord Herald.
Whoa, so just out of nowhere, you're like, come. We're not
let
friends.
Let us return to Haven.
I mean, we're not friends yet, but you should come meet with me, because we could be friends. My guy's like, I don't know what the hell's going on. Nicholas Mage, I have no clue either. The Summer Bazaar. Mm-hmm. What else we got? Founding of the Chantry. Oh. The third one never makes it. We never make it to the third one. It's probably some detailed information back there. Secrets. To every waterfall treasure chest in the game. Tough shit. You did not scroll fast enough, bro. Alright. Let's run up here. Lucy, I'm home! No one here to greet me. Story of my life. There's more Chantry people here than in the damn Chantry city.
Lights in the shadow. In their blood, the
yep, Scraper. Them Scraper. All right, in we go. I think I got some war table stuff to do as well. Ooh, and I have to turn in things. Uh-oh. First, I have a cutscene. What up,
it's
Josephine?
You've returned. We heard of your encounter.
You heard?
My agents in a city sent word ahead, of course.
It's a shame the Templars have abandoned their senses, as well as the capital.
Mm-hmm. But going there was worth... Yeah, at least we made contact. Yeah, going there was worth the risk.
We had to do something, and now we have an opportunity.
Yes, and we have the opening we need to approach the Templars and the Mages.
Do we? Lord Seeker Lucius is not the man I remember.
True, he has taken the order somewhere, but to do what? My reports have been very odd.
We must look into it. I'm certain not everyone in the Order will support the Lord Seeker.
Or the Herald could simply go to meet the mages in Redcliffe instead.
You think the Mage Rebellion is more united? It could be 10 times worse.
I mean, we have to do both, right? Like, we need to meet the mages to figure out what they're up to, but we need to find the Templars to figure out what they're up to. Wait, I could just say, you must choose soon? No, dude, I'm the one in charge. You must choose soon. Alright, well, we know where the mages are. They're in Redcliffe, so we should probably find the Templars, so at least we know what they're up to.
I think the Templars are worth investigating.
I agree. What could the Lord Seeker be up to?
We shouldn't discount Redcliffe. The mages may be worth the risk.
I agree with that.
They are powerful, Ambassador, but more desperate than you realize.
You think it's a trap? They could be useful. There's always danger. Yeah! The Nicholas Mage way.
So it'll be dangerous. I've been in danger since I walked out of the Fade.
If some among the rebel mages were responsible for what happened at the Conclave,
the same could be said about the Templars.
True enough. Right now, I'm not certain we have enough influence to approach the Order safely.
Then the Inquisition needs agents in more places. That's something you can help with.
In the meantime, we should consider other options.
I agree with all of you. You all offer valid points. I'm not sure why we're...
There is one other matter. Several months ago, the Grey Wardens of Ferelden vanished. I sent word to those in Orlais, but they have also disappeared. Ordinarily, I wouldn't even consider the idea they're involved in all this, but the timing is curious.
Well, if anyone knows about Grey Wardens, I think you would. Sounds suspicious.
That does sound odd, I agree.
The others have disregarded my suspicion, but I cannot ignore it. 2 days ago, my agents in the Hinterlands heard news of a Grey Warden by the name of Blackwall. If you have the opportunity, please seek him out. Perhaps he can put my mind at ease.
And if he can't?
Then there may be more going on than we thought.
Guys, I mean, she's giving me a quest to go back to the Hinterlands. I can't not go back to the Hinterlands, guys. I mean, that would be crazy not to. All right, my influence grows. Oh, we have to go turn in stuff, I think.
Ah, Lord Trevelyan. May I have a moment?
Go on. Well, actually, hold on. We gotta turn stuff in.
We will study that.
Thank you very much. All right. Yes, go on. Talk to me under my formal name.
Yes, Ambassador?
I'd like to discuss your parents.
Well, that was quick. Yes!
A little sudden, but it's time someone made an honest man of me.
What? Very amusing. This is serious. I'd like to dispatch a courier asking the bands of House Trevelyan to align themselves with us. What are your thoughts? Should we approach your family for their formal support of the Inquisition?
Do I have any special fancy flirt options left? Not if it puts them in danger. Yeah. I think that would work. Not if it puts them in danger.
We already have enemies. I don't want my family caught up in this mess.
They may be drawn in regardless. Valroyo has noted your lineage. It gives the Inquisition some legitimacy, although not so much as we'd hoped.
Why not?
You are from Ostwick. Orlesian nobles consider the Free Marches somewhat quaint.
How dare they? They're not scared I'm a mage? Yeah, maybe let's try that. I'd call us disorganized. Let's try this.
Even though I'm a mage, that doesn't give them pause.
You're not an unfamiliar sight. Mages from noble families are given more leeway. Besides, Ostwick Circle had a reputation for being rather sedate.
You mean dull. I like the quiet. I hate the confinement. I do like that. You mean dull.
You've never been bored until you've lived in a tower of studious, well-behaved mages. Even our circle's fall was quiet. Everyone just left.
No wonder the people's faith in Templars has been shaken.
I fancied one of the Templars. I'm not going to tell her that. Why would you tell her that? The money helped. Yeah, I didn't mind the Templars.
Templars at Ostwick were even-handed enough. A few were almost friendly.
Commander Cullen would be pleased. For a man no longer with the Order, he takes its faults quite personal. This place is no bastion of civilization. Not like the Circle. I hope you don't find the living conditions in Haven too drastic for someone of your station.
Oh, how do you find it?
This can't be what you're accustomed to, Ambassador.
One adjusts. I stay busy. It helps take my mind from our surroundings. And the gold. And the wildlife. And the lack of civilization for miles around. Why anyone lived here before we found Andraste's ashes, I cannot imagine.
At least the... maybe I could be like, I'm fine. Nah, we'll say this. At least the isolation's safe.
Having a few leagues of ice between me and whoever wishes me ill can't hurt.
Do not say that too loudly. Chancellor Roderick is still here. Well, until next time, my lord.
Until next time, Josephine. Oh, ho, ho. Blossoming love. Oh, I think I should probably go in here and do our War Council stuff. Looks like there's a quest in here. All right, team, what we doing? What is that dagger on the table? Conquered by Ole. Okay, we have two things. We have one that is...
Has Cassandra spoken to you about my new recruits?
They are not your recruits, Commander. They're ours.
Yeah, gathering coin, 117. Thank you. This is done. That's done. That's done. That's done. That requires 15 power, which I don't have. And this is new. The Cult of Andraste. Before the Fifth Blight and the arrival of the Hero of Ferelden, Haven was occupied by cultists who worshipped a dragon, one they believed to be Andraste reborn. Both the cultists and their dragon were long gone by the time the Chantry arrived to build the Temple of Sacred Ashes, but there may still be undiscovered passages in the mountains containing their relics. With a concerted search effort, it might be possible to unearth something useful to the Inquisition. Well, I mean, yeah, this task is best left to a few select agents, or I'm leery of what might find these passages, but we have enough soldiers for the search. No, we gotta go with Liliana on this one. Josephine can't even go. I could be political and ask questions. She just wants to stay here with me. Look, I don't blame her.
Let's see what we have.
I don't blame her at all. All right, cool. Back. Oh, I could gather more coin, though. I will definitely do that. All right, we'll use Josephine. Done.
At your service.
Nice. Okay. What's going on over here? So we have this dagger. Address the Chantry. Chantry remains? The confrontation with Mother... Actually, before we even read that. Yeah, all right. So there's much better... Oh, my goodness. All right, we'll come back then when we actually have access to those people. What be these? Investigate the shards. Sister Liliana, the shards acquired by the Herald of Andraste are unlike anything I've encountered. Though ancient in origin, few have been recovered before now. The breach must have disrupted whatever ancient magic was concealing them from view. I have heard of one scroll that mentions the shards. It belonged to the Circle Tower in Markham. However, after the circles fell, the Sorrel family seized many of the valuables as compensation for donations made after their mage son was taken there. They intend to sell the scroll along with everything else at private auction. Everything's locked, but the use of connections. I feel like that we should do, but it's going to use 4 power. And I don't want to use 4 power yet, so let's go back. And we'll go back again. I feel like what's going to happen is we're going to have to go back to the Hinterlands. Although, there may be other options. Speak with the messenger, captain of the chargers. Let's see what's that's just them talking about the maker. All right, so there's the war room. What's going on in there? Just go to the war room. What is this? What is this right out here?
There is but one God, one life, one death.
Krem?
But one God.
Hello?
Excuse me. I've got a message for the Inquisition, but I'm having a hard time getting anyone to talk to me.
Identify yourself.
Who are you, soldier?
Chromisius Aclasi with the Bull's Charges Mercenary Company. We mostly work out of Orlais and Navarra. We've got word of some Devinter mercenaries gathering out on the Storm Coast. My company commander, Iron Bull, offers the information free of charge.
Nice.
If you'd like to see what the Bull's Charges can do for the Inquisition, meet us there and watch us work.
Huh. Okay. Tell me about your company.
What can your Bull's Chargers offer the Inquisition?
We're loyal, we're tough, and we don't break contracts. Ask around Val Royeau. We've got references.
Also, we cannot sit still for a minute. We have got to keep moving.
What should I know about your commander?
Iron Bull. He's one of those Canari, the big guys with the horns. He leads from the front. He pays well, and he's a lot smarter than the last bastard I worked for. Best of all, he's professional. We accept contracts with whoever makes the first real offer. You're the first time he's gone out of his way to pick a side.
Why give us this message?
Why did your commander send us this information?
Iron Bull wants to work for the Inquisition. He thinks you're doing good work.
Great. All right. You're welcome to help.
I look forward to meeting this Iron Bull.
We're the best you'll find. Come to the Storm Coast and you can see us in action.
Well, balls. I guess that's answers that. That's where we're going. We have to go there. That's it for this episode, guys. Tune in next time. We'll head to the Storm Coast. We'll see what's going on with our new allies, possibly. And weren't there some Grey Wardens in the area? So there's a lot going on there. We have to go explore. So I think that's what we'll do next time. Stay tuned, as always, to your million subs. Subscribe, please. Like, comment, all that stuff. And as always, to be continued.